This is one of my favorite Thrive recipes. It's a black bean and corn salsa that is so easy to make. It's colorful, it uses a lot of Thrive ingredients, and most importantly, it tastes delicious. So what I'm starting out with is I'm starting out with some Thrive pinto and black beans. Now, on our website and in our Thrive cookbook, you can find information on the two different methods in which to soak and cook beans. There's a quick method, and then there's an overnight method of soaking. And we've also got a bean chart on there that tells you how long you need to cook each specific type of bean. So I'm starting today with these beans that have already been cooked. It's nice to make up a big batch and use them throughout the week so that you're not having to go back and cook beans every single day. And that's what we've done here. So we've got our beans and we have our Thrive freeze-dried corn, probably one of my favorite ingredients in the line. And this is after it's been rehydrated. So what we did here is we took the corn straight from the can, covered it with water, let it rehydrate for about 5 to 10 minutes, and then drained it really good. And this is what it looked like. It's the next best thing to fresh corn. It's harvested at its peak season, it's freeze-dried, and kept for uses just like this. This is going to go right into our bowl here. It's so sweet and delicious, and a great ingredient to use out of the line. Mix this up a little. To that, I'm going to add a can of green chilies. Although not Thrive, they're canned, so it's a nice thing to include into your food storage. Some fresh cilantro, which makes a big difference. It's not necessary, but it kind of gives it an extra flavor boost. And last but not least, a chopped red onion. Now, if you wanted to go ahead and use the Thrive freeze-dried onion, that would be just fine. I like using a red onion in this case because I like the bright red color, and an onion has a very potent flavor and adds a lot of flavor by adding just a little bit, and I like that, especially when you're using a lot of freeze-dried products or canned goods. To add one or two fresh ingredients kind of gives it an extra boost, and people will never know you're cooking with food storage. Okay, now that that's come together, those colors look so vibrant and beautiful. I'm going to make a really quick dressing. I'm going to add a little bit of oil, some vinegar, and a little bit of sugar. And just let this come together. If you didn't want to take the time to heat this up, that's just fine. By heating it up a little bit, it intensifies those flavors. So not too long, I just like to maybe bring it to a boil, let it simmer, and then I'm going to pour it right over the top of this salsa. Obviously, it's great to serve this salsa with tortilla chips, with maybe our whole wheat tortillas that you can find on the website in the book. It's delicious. It's great along quesadillas or bean burritos, things of those natures. It's just a great recipe to have on hand and use for so many different occasions. Okay. Like I said, I just want this to get a little warm to really allow those flavors to marry, and then we're going to pour it right over the top here. That should be great. There we go, and I'm going to mix all of this together, and I've got a delicious salsa that can be used for so many things. This is a great recipe to take to a party. Everyone's going to be asking for it by the time you leave. And most importantly, it tastes delicious. Give this recipe a try. I'm sure you won't be disappointed by our black bean and corn salsa.